In this lecture, we will discuss about HP UFT add-ins. First, we will try to understand basic concept of add-in and then we will look into HP UFT specific add-ins. We already discussed that add-ins are required to recognize objects. And whenever I say object, just remember that I am talking about front-end objects. Front-end objects are checkbox, radio button, drop-down, combo box, etc. And they can be made by using HTML, Java, .NET or any other technologies. So, to recognize different type of objects, we need different add-ins. Because add-in provides environment compatible files. And by default, HP UFT does not support all test environment. And that is the reason we need to add add-in in order to perform testing on different environments. Suppose you want to test web-based application, then you need web-based add-in. For SAP application, SAP add-in. And for .NET applications, you need .NET add-ins. By now, we know that why add-ins are required. Add-ins are required to make testing environment compatible with the test environment to recognize objects for testing. Now, these add-ins are of two types. First is internal add-in and the next one is external add-in. Internal add-in comes with basic license. So whenever we install a trial version or a default version, internal add-in comes with it. Whereas external add-ins. So for external add-ins, we have to pay extra. And external add-ins does not come with default license. Now let's see the list of different add-ins. First, we will look into internal add-ins. So first one is standard window. And it is a built-in add-in. If you see in the installation manager, this add-in will not be visible because it's an inbuilt add-in. Next one is ActiveX, Visual Basics and Web. So all these four add-ins are internal add-ins and comes with default license. Now let's move to the external add-ins. So all these are external add-ins, but I'm not going to go through all of this. And if you are interested, then all these add-ins are described in the attached resources and you can have a look into them. And the resource is attached with this video itself. Now, what I am interested in is how to select these add-ins. I will try to make you understand this by going through a scenario. So now let's have a look into the scenario. Suppose you have three web applications which is developed using Java technology. So this is application 1, application 2 and application 3. To test application 1, you are using only web-based add-in. To test application 2, you are using web-based add-in and ActiveX. And to test application 3, you are using web-based add-in, ActiveX, as well as Java add-ins. Now the question is, though all the applications developed using Java technology, why we are using different add-ins to test these applications? To answer this, you can pause this video and think for a while. So I hope you got the answer by now. Now let's see the explanation. Since our tool is a front-end tool, what matters to us is how the front-end objects are developed and not how the web is developed. So what you have to note here is how the front-end object is developed, what technology we used there, not how the web is developed. So front-end object can be developed using HTML and internal functionality can be developed using Java, PHP or .NET or any other technology. So you have to differentiate here. The front-end object means the UI, user interface object, can be developed using HTML, but its logic can be developed using Java applications. So if we apply this concept here, so suppose First application, front-end object is designed using HTML only, and the internal functionalities are developed using Java. So for first application, we need only web add-ins because the front-end object is developed only using HTML. So that is what matters, that how we developed our front object. Since here the front object was developed using HTML, so we need only web add-in. Similarly, in the second application, suppose the front-end object is designed using HTML and there is a possibility we are using some other front-end objects like calendar. And in order to support calendar objects, we need ActiveS. For HTML, we need web add-ins, and for calendar, we need ActiveX. And that is the reason we are using two add-ins here. Now moving to the third application, here there is a possibility the front-end object is developed using HTML, then we are using calendar, and some of the front-end objects are also developed using Java. So in this case, we need web-based add-in for HTML, ActiveX for calendar, and Java for Java-based object. So this is how we have to select add-ins depending upon what we are going to test. How is our user interface? Depending upon that, we have to select the add-ins. So selection of add-ins are based on user interface. And while installing software, we will practically have a look on these add-ins, how we are going to select these add-ins. So this is it from my side in this lecture, and I will see you with the next topic. Thank you.